Welcome to the next session on Fourier. We are doing inverse discrete time Fourier transform in this session. So let us learn inverse discrete time Fourier transform. So if we are very strong in the property, it's nothing we can do in the same way how we did in the DT. So now, what is a power n u of n? Is nothing but its DTFT is 1 by 1 minus a e power minus 0. So now the same question, if I have 1 by 2 as a constant, here it will be 1 by 2. Now let us repeat the issue. What is its inverse DTFT? Is nothing but a power n u of n. At that time you should remember this. In case if I have 1 by 1 plus b e power minus j omega, what should be its I DTFT, inverse DTFT? It will be minus b power n u of n, because plus b minus. If it is 4 here, then it will be 4, just multiplying by the constant. With this preamble, we can start some problem in inverse DTFT. Okay, let us start. What is x of e power j omega? 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 e power minus j. Find I DTFT. Now, what we should do in the same way, I DTFT of 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 e power minus j omega. The result will be 1 by 2 power n u of n. In case if you have 1 by 5 here, the same problem is 1 by 5. Make note of it. Find I DTFT. If this term is not there, which is resembling 1 by 1 minus the general format, so I DTFT of 1 by 1 minus 1 by 5 e power minus j. Additionally, I DTFT of e power minus j 3 omega 1 minus 1 by 5 e power minus j. Now, what is its result? 1 by 5 power n u of n as per the basic format. Here, be careful with this particular explanation. 1 by 5 power n u of n, if this term is not, okay, this term is not. In time domain shifting, in frequency domain e power j. Now the same statement. In frequency domain shifting, time domain e power j. Now you should know analysis. In one domain e power j, other domain shifting. In this domain e power j, obviously in this domain shifting, where time shift, same shift, so minus 3, that's right. Find I DT. Now the issue here is, in denominator we are having a quadratic formula, right? Second order things, so it won't work out. We can do directly I DT. One simple suggestion, just replace e power minus j omega by a simple variable, let us say m. Just replace it. If I do, what will happen to the given question 6 divided by? Your e power minus j omega is m the whole square minus 5 m plus. That's the simplest analysis. No need to think about left hand side, just to do it right hand side. Now, we can just split this as a factor 6 divided by, let us do into 2 factors, obviously 2 and 3, both are minus, okay. So, minus 2, minus 3 is minus 5, 2 into 3 is 6, okay, right. Now, I will have to do partial fraction of this. 6 divided by m minus 2, m minus 3, because I have 2 factors. I want a single factor in the denominator, a by m minus 2 plus b by m minus 3. Please recall what we learnt in the z transform, divide by z, am I right? But here we no need, let numerator be a constant because What is my general format? Please remember, a power n u of n is 1 by 1 minus a e power minus 0. Who is in the numerator? 1, which is a constant. So you can maintain the constant a b as it is. Now if you cross multiply, 6 a into m minus 3 plus b into m minus 2. So put m is equal to 3, 6 a into 0 plus b into 3 minus 2 is 1. Therefore b is 6. Yes. Next, put m is equal to 2. If you substitute 6 a 2 minus 3 is minus 1 plus b 0. Therefore a is equal to minus 6. If I resubstitute, what will be the result now? Let us repeat that. A value is minus 6 divided by m minus 2. B value is 6 divided by m minus 3. When I converted e power minus j omega as m to make partial fraction simpler. But my cosine is not m, it is e power j omega. So remove it. Okay. So again replace by e power minus j omega. E power minus j omega minus 2, 6 e power minus j omega minus 3. Okay, but careful. What was my general format? Please recall, 1 by 1 minus a e power minus j omega. Okay, so which is not satisfying here, the same format. I need e power minus j omega as a second term. Let me just shuffle. Minus 6 divided by minus 2 plus e power minus j omega. 6 divided by minus 3 e power minus j omega. Just a simple mathematics. A minus b. I made minus b plus a. I just shuffled the both of you. Now again recall the second term e power minus j omega. Satisfied? First term should be 1 as per my general formula. First term must be 1. So here divide by minus 2. Okay. If you divide by minus 2, it will be 3 divided by 1 minus 1 by 2 e power minus j. Right? If you divide by 2, it will be 3 minus minus cancel. If you divide by minus 2, gets cancelled 1. My aim is to get 1. If you divide by 2, it is 1 by 2, but minus 1 is minus. Same you do here. Divide by minus 3, because then only it will become 1. Now, if you divide by minus 3, it will be minus 2 divided by 1 minus 1 by 3 e power j. Minus it is it. 6 divided by 3 is 2. Minus is that. Minus 3 is getting cancelled 1. Divided by 3 is okay. Now who is e? X of e power minus j. Now, what is the total mathematics I did here is to break it into 2 as a positive sum. So I modified as a so that it becomes very simple for me. Now let us do inverse DTFT. Directly you can do, because we already learned in many things, many places. 1 by 2 power n u of n for these constant 3. 1 by 3 power n u of n constant minus 2. Okay. I cannot do that. Find IDTFT using convolution property. Okay, just they are giving us tips that you should do by convolution property. Now if I break this into 2, what will be the given question? 1 by 1 minus a e power minus j omega, the whole square, multiplied by 1 by 1 minus a e power minus j omega, both are same. So if you multiply it, it is square. Now, what is your conclusion? This is a frequency domain. This is a frequency domain. Two frequency domains are there. Multiplication in frequency domain is convolution in the time domain. That is what they explain, convolution property. Now, if I do directly IDTFT, what is the result x of n for this term? A power n u of n. For this term, a power n u of n. Multiplication in frequency, convolution in time. Okay, that is the property. Like we always say, conservation in time domain, multiplication in frequency domain. Okay, so this is your answer. But we should solve this convolution, but let us not go for the graphical method. We will do it directly with the formula. Now, what is now your x of n? I have to implement convolution. I need a convolution formula. Okay, just recall. X of n convolution h of n is equal to y of n. Okay. Can you recall what is your y of n, which we learnt in convolution? Summation x of k h of n minus k, where k equal to minus infinity infinity. Please do remember your convolution formula. But don't try to reproduce as it is. That's not good. Now try to learn the concept. First signal available. Next signal available. Okay. First signal available, which is your first signal. This is the first signal. Second signal, h of n, which is your second signal in the second signal. Now let us implement that. Summation k equal to minus infinity infinity cancel. First signal, write as it is, n become k. First signal write as it is, n become k. First signal write as it is, n become k, u of k. Second signal write as it is, n become n minus k. N become n minus k, a power n minus k, u of n minus k. That is the implementation of your convolution formula. The talent lies here. So, the formula which we know already in the second model, that is convolution, just I am implementing the same first signal n minus k, second signal n become n minus k, first signal n become k. Very good. Now, you should know what are the definition for unit step signal. You know it is 1. What is the definition of unit step signal? You know it is 1. But where? What is the position? So, when I recall any unit step function, please do remember, its amplitude is 1. Which side? Right side. In left side, what is the amplitude? 0. So, what is my conclusion? In right side, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, be careful. If I say unit step, what is the value? U of 2 will be 1. U of 5 will be 1. U of 200 will be 1. U of 0 will be 1. Which means, right side, 2, 5, positive side is 1. U of minus 3 is 0. U of minus 1 is 0. U of minus 10 is 0. Now give me one conclusion. When it is 0, in the negative side. When it is 1, in the positive side. Repeating. When it is 0, when within bracket is negative. When it is 1, when within bracket is positive, that is greater than 0. In fact, greater than or equal to 0. 0 and up. Let us implement that concept here. Now carefully remember, when this is 1, when within bracket k is greater than or equal to 0, right? This is the k value right now. That term should be greater than 0. Same concept. When this is 1, within bracket n minus k is greater than or equal to 0. Under that condition, right side. Now, my aim is, what is the limit k? So, I am talking about the variable k. Repeating, I am talking about the variable k. Then telling you, who is k? Well, k is greater than 0. Who is k only you should be, okay? So, n is greater than or equal to k. Ashafi, k is less than or equal to n. Try to recall these two. So, who are you concentrated for k? Because the limit is k. The limit is k, the variable is k, let us talk about k. K is greater than 0, k is less than 1. What does the conclusion tell me? Your k is greater than 0, at the same time your k is lesser than n. So, whatever your k, that's the generalizing integer. Your k must be greater than 0 and lesser than n. So, what we conclude? This is going to help us for your lower limit. This is going to help us for your upper. Under these conditions, under this limit, its value is 1, its value is 1. Who is next? A power k, a power n minus k. If you want, you can break this a power u, a power minus k. Am I right? So, what is the next issue? If you multiply these two, power will be k minus k gets cancelled. So, your final answer will be summation k equal to 0 to n, which will be a power n. So, you can say a power n outside because limit is for k, you know. A power n, k equal to 0 to n, 1. Its answer is a power n, upper limit plus 1. So, who is he? This is your x power n. This is your final answer. So, I have identified the inverse DTFT using the convolution property as well as using the convolution formula. But make sure that when you do such problem, use this concept. One will talk about lower limit, other will talk about higher limit. Using this, the limit is defined. Under that limit, its value is known. So, we will do more discussion about Fourier in further session.